Welcome to our August monthly mortgage and market update for the Denver metro area. Nicole, thank you so much for joining us. We have a lot to talk about today. Yes. First and foremost, I'm sure your phones have been ringing off the hook. The Fed raised the interest rates yet again. We know we love this time when they always raise the interest rates on us. So what should buyers expect for mortgages? Anyone in the buyer pool out there who's listening to this, what should the buyers expect right now?
That is a fantastic question, because we got that question all the way when the Fed was lowering the Fed rate. Like, I want that zero rate. I'm like, that right. Actually doesn't exist.
Right.
But it's a fair question. So what just happened with the Fed? Because they raised the Fed rate last Wednesday as expected. Those two words actually tell you exactly what happened in the market. Nothing. The market was actually quiet because we had baked in the fact there was a 99% chance that they were going to raise the Fed rate a quarter. What everyone was listening for was, what are they going to do next? Because the anticipation is that they're going to skip August and raise the rate again in September. So is that going to actually happen? What he said during the meeting, Powell did, was a lot about the fact that we are going to be data dependent. We are not forecasting. We are looking backwards. We are going to be data dependent. Regretfully for us, on Thursday, that was Wednesday, on Thursday, we had four reports that came out, all showing how strong the economy was. The initial jobless claims came out lower. The manufacturing came out higher. We saw several economic factors and reports all coming out stronger, which showed him that yes, inflation is slowly coming down, slowly, but the economy is still doing well. It's very resilient. That had more impact on our interest rates than Wednesday. On Thursday, we saw our interest rates go up above 7% again. Not on Wednesday, not with the Fed rate, because that was already baked in. Our mortgage rates are not directly tied to the Fed rate. They are more indirectly tied because they are directly tied to the same economic indicators.
Are there any silver linings for buyers out there, buyers that still want to stay in the market, still want to keep hunting for those houses? Because inventory's up. I mean, we're in like the dog days of summer is what we like to call it. So inventory's getting up because all the leftover inventory from the spring season and now into the summer season. So what are some silver linings for buyers out there?
So the silver lining is pretty massive in the sense that if you're looking at a home that might not have just come on the market, if a home is priced right and staged right, it's going to go under contract very quickly and more than likely with multiple bids and for over asking. If that home is not perfect, then it might sit on the market for a weekend, 2 weekends, several weeks. And if that's the case, as a buyer right now, there are less overall buyers. Now, the buyers that are out are intentional, but there are less overall buyers. So you might find one of those homes that isn't perfectly staged, perfectly priced, and you have the ability with the higher interest rates, while 64% of the buyers, would-be buyers, are sitting on the sidelines waiting for interest rates to drop, you have the ability to negotiate. You can negotiate a 2-1 buy down. You can negotiate better terms, a lower purchase price, more upgrades based on the inspection items. You have the negotiating power as a buyer right now in this market with higher interest rates.
Absolutely. And that's where I come into play, because I can help you negotiate that depending on your motivation and what you're looking for to get out of that perfect dream home coming to you. Yes. So what about sellers? I mean, we have a lot of sellers on the market, like you just said, that might be sitting on the market, might have come out overpriced, might not have the right staging, might not have the right curb appeal. I know a lot of sellers that I talk to feel almost stuck in some point because they bought during COVID. Maybe they bought during that height of COVID when interest rates were down in the lower threes, maybe upper twos, you know? So now they might want to upsize, they might want to downsize. They might want to move to another state. And now they like, oh my gosh, I don't want to lose my interest rates. So there are some options that we can talk about. One from my standpoint is that a lot of people are now renting out that home. They've been in that home for 2 years now, and they're going to move into another primary residence and then keep that interest rate, but then rent it out and make hopefully some profit on that. Anything else that sellers that you're hearing from about them feeling stuck right now?
We're, you know, over 90% of all mortgages are locked in under 6%. And you got to think almost 40% of all homes don't even have a mortgage. So you have a lot of people that have a very good equity position, and they have a financial strength right now with a budget, with a mortgage payment that meets their budget or lack thereof, a mortgage payment altogether. So those folks are not going to be as enticed to move, or even if they want to move, maybe they'll think, God, I want to pay more for a smaller house. Well, I would say that you have to let your life dictate, number one. If it's time to move, you just got divorced, married, had a baby, downsizing, you know, those things are beyond interest rates. Interest rates should not stop your life from moving forward. But the other option is, as you just mentioned, which is the renting out the existing home. You only need to live in that home for 1 year, and then you can convert it to a rental and earn income on that home. And if it's locked in at one of those lower interest rates, your cash flow opportunities are substantially better than if you bought that home today.
And the queen of investing, who I'm talking to right now, Miss Nicole, if any of you have any questions about building your investment empire, Nicole has the exact class, the exact topic of just that you need to take from her. I will have all that information down below. Anything else we need to discuss, Nicole? Anything else going on in the mortgage world that people need to know about? Or did we cover it all?
I can talk for hours. Right. But there are opportunities. Right now, we're doing a lot more temporary buy downs, the 2-1 buy downs. And we just rolled out the 2-1 buy down for jumbo loans, which is super important in a market like Denver. We're also doing, on the flip side, we're doing a lot of down payment assistance programs. Number one, because they help somebody get out of the spin cycle of renting and not building any wealth or equity. But number two, if you have a lower credit score, you might not have thought about this, but using down payment assistance might actually get you a better interest rate in a market like this where interest rates are higher, because they have a fixed interest rate no matter what your credit score is. So we're doing a lot of down payment assistance with or without the down payment assistance part, and getting a lot of our buyers even lower interest rates based on maybe having more bumps or bruises or lower credit scores. So being creative, taking advantage of less buyers in this market, grabbing some of that inventory that's coming on the market, and then looking towards refinancing down the road when interest rates do drop, gives yourself the best positioning.
So much creativity and so much strategy that buyers and sellers both alike out there can do. So if any of you have questions and you want to create some strategic lessons, some strategic plans with Miss Nicole, I will have all information down below. And if any sellers or buyers, you out there are ready to get going on your real estate needs, I'll have all on my information down below as well. And I look forward to helping you. Nicole looks forward to helping you as well. Nicole, until next time, we will chat soon.
Thank you. Bye-bye.